मिनिस्टर ट्रांसपोर्ट श्री पुवाड़ अजय कुमार गारू, ऑनरेबल मिनिस्टर फॉर फॉरेस्ट एनवायरनमेंट साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी एंडोमेंट्स एंड लॉ श्री इंद्रकरण रेड्डी गारू, ऑनरेबल प्रिंसिपल सेक्रेटरी ऑफ रोड्स एंड बिल्डिंग्स एंड ट्रांसपोर्ट श्री सुनील शर्मा गारू, ऑनरेबल प्रिंसिपल सेक्रेटरी इंडस्ट्री एंड आईटी श्री जयेश रंजन गारू, टीएसआईसी एमडी गारू नरसिंहारेड्डी गारू, टीएस रेडको एमडी जानय गारू, टू ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट्स यू नो हू जस्ट साइंड मेमोरेंडम्स ऑफ अंडरस्टैंडिंग विद द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ तेलंगाना एंड टू ऑल द फ्रेंड्स इन द गैदरिंग हियर, अ वार्म वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू. बिफोर आई गोइंग टू माय फॉर्मल स्पीच, आई वुड ऑल्सो लाइक टू एक्नॉलेज माय बैड, यू नो वी लिव इन अ वर्चुअल रियलिटी काइंड ऑफ सिचुएशन टुडे, सो आई फॉरगॉट टू acknowledge Sri Pavan Goenka, who's joined us specially, the chairman, so CEO of Mahindra Group, and Sri Sunil Mehtaji of the Yes Bank Group, and Srimati Anna Roy from Niti Aayog. Thank you, madam, for joining us. And please do convey to Mr. Amitabh Kant that we missed him. Before I go into my formal speech, I just wanted to say one thing quickly. You know, I was talking to a friend of mine, you know, after seeing what's been happening around the world, you know, during the pandemic, how nature was healing itself. And I was getting all these videos on social media, how nature really is healing and how the world is so much of a better place, you know, without humans kind of killing whatever we've been doing, kind of doing, inflicting all the damage we've done. One of the things a very learned and a very, you know, knowledgeable friend of mine said, I said, what is the solution going forward as from a government perspective? What do we do to make sure that you know, we help our environment, we pass on a better planet to our children? What do we do? He said something very, very interesting. He said, follow the 3D mantra. I said, what is that? And he said, first thing, focus on decarbonization. Second, focus even more on digitization. And thirdly, focus also on decentralization. Now, I don't need to explain to any of you in this room, decarbonization or digitization. I think you all know it rather well. Now, what did he mean by decentralization? I think what he meant was, see, I also wear the other hat of Minister for Urban Development and Municipal Administration. One of the biggest challenges I face in that ministry is the rapid urbanization and suburbanization that is sweeping our nation. Today, Telangana, in fact, is one of the most urbanized states in India. We're almost 43-44% urban population. And in about 5 to 7 years, in fact, majority of Telangana would be living in urban areas and minority would be living in rural areas. That's the reality. Now, how do we address this? Why do people migrate? Why do people urbanize? People urbanize in search of better livelihoods, in search of better Medicare facilities, in search of better education facilities. So what this learned friend of mine meant was, decentralize. While we can't completely contain urbanization, at least we can hope for suburbanization in a structured, planned way. Create more counter magnets. Create more integrated townships. Ensure that people actually move further away. Create more economic clusters around the city of Hyderabad, as was pointed out by Mr. Goenka. While Mahatma Gandhi was right when he said, India lives in its villages, the fact today, after 75 years of independence, is India is run by its cities. Today, our cities have become the epicenters of economic activity. Today, for instance, if you take the example of Hyderabad, nearly 50% of state GSDP comes from our capital city. Nearly 50% of Telangana's GSDP is contributed by Hyderabad. So therefore, it's extremely important to conserve, to preserve, and to ensure that the economic vitality our cities offer remains intact. If we are to grow into a 5 trillion economy, as our Honorable Prime Minister keeps alluding to, or if you really have to get into the league of developed first world countries, as we all combinedly dream of every so often. Now, how do we achieve that? How do we go about doing it? Recently, there was floods in Hyderabad. We all know that. Cloud bursts, climate changes, unseasonal rains are not only affecting urban denizens, they're also affecting our farmers. They're also affecting people across the world. Now, one of the nicest things and one of the most interesting things I've heard today from the previous speakers was sustainable mobility. You know, we talk about sustainable energy all the time. But today I heard Pawan Goenka mentioned about sustainable mobility. He also talked about shared mobility. Now, these are the things I think our cities today need if we really have to ensure that we preserve their fabric, we preserve their growth momentum, and we grow into a league of first world country in years to come, years that lie ahead of us. Now, having said that, I believe what has been accomplished is very little, but what lies ahead, the road that lies ahead in terms of ensuring that we get there with respect to sustainable energy and also sustainable mobility is going to be an arduous, is going to be a difficult journey, but I think with all stakeholders participating, governments in cities, governments in state, government in Delhi, and also, when I say Delhi, I don't mean Kejriwal, I mean Government of India, and also all stakeholders, the private sector, the startups, the large OEMs, the aggregators, all of us working together, I think will be, therein lies the real success of this policy launch today. Of course, as was pointed out by my friends earlier, Telangana, in fact, has come out with an extremely comprehensive policy. It just does not talk about electric vehicles in itself. We also have ensured that the energy storage policy is dovetailed with our electric vehicle policy, because these are two extremely, tight-knit ideas which need to work together cohesively. Now, I'm also delighted that two very important ministers and their are seated on the dais. For this electric vehicle policy to be successful, I think these three ministries need to work together very, very closely. One is, of course, to promote investments, to promote innovation, industry and IT ministry, which is represented by myself and Jayesh Ranjan. We need to be working closely with our colleagues to ensure that electric vehicles are adopted and people actually lap them up. We need to work closely with Honorable Minister for Transport and his secretary, and to ensure that whatever we do remains in consonance with environment. We need the support of Honorable Minister for Environment, Science and Technology. So the fact that Telangana government has not only thought this through in terms of policy, but also in terms of ensuring that the policy is enforced effectively, implemented effectively, we brought out all stakeholders, and this multi-stakeholder engagement, I believe, will lead to a very successful implementation of this policy that our state has come out with. As I pointed out, Hyderabad is today our capital city, and it is the epicenter of our economic activity. This city today, in fact, I urge not only Mr. Pawan Goenka and to every electric vehicle manufacturer in the city, our dream today, in fact, as we launch this policy, is to make great strides of progress in electric vehicle adoption, and also make our city and our state the epicenter of electric vehicle manufacturing and adoption. Now, I offer the city of Hyderabad as a test case for all electric vehicle manufacturers to come and work with us. Come and work with our Hyderabad Metro Rail. Come and work with our MMTS. Come and work with our RTC, and see how together we can explore better public transportation solutions, better shared mobility solutions with our aggregators, Uber, Ola, and many others out there. We could work together jointly to ensure that more and more people are taken away from their private vehicles, which are gas guzzlers today, to these wonderful vehicles which are environmental friendly.